located off the coast of São Paulo, Brazil. 33 kilometers into the vast Atlantic Ocean, lies one of the most dangerous places on Earth. But why is it called the Snake Island? How did it become home to one of the world's most deadly snakes? And, is there really a hidden treasure? But before we dive in, click on that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss out on the craziest stories and the most interesting facts. Back to the video. Before grabbing your phone and booking a flight to Brazil on a mission to become the next Jack Sparrow and hunt the hidden treasure, you should know the island is probably off limits to you. Unless you are on the list of authorized scientific researchers or government officials, you're not allowed to get on the island. In the matter of fact, you should be happy. The Snake Island was previously thought to have a population of one snake per square meter. Converting the 43 hectares, which is equivalent to 106 acres, to square meters, we would end up with an area of 430,000 square meters, which would total a daunting population of 430,000 snakes. This number was most likely never real, as such a small area would not have enough prey to sustain the life of 430,000 snakes. But in recent studies, the island is estimated to be home to between 2,000 and 4,000 snakes. Now, you are probably asking yourself, if the numbers are way lower, how does it still hold the reputation as one of the most dangerous places on Earth? Well, it's one of those cases where quality outperforms quantity. The island is home to one of the world's most deadly snakes, the Golden Lancehead Vipers. These snakes can usually grow to about 70 to 90 centimeters, or 27 to 35 inches. However, some individuals have been reported to grow up to 110 centimeters, which is equivalent to 43 inches in length. The size and growth of these vipers can vary depending on several factors such as age, sex, diet, and environmental conditions. Their average lifespan is between 15 to 20 years, but in some cases, they can live up to 30 years old. But what makes the Golden Lancehead Vipers so deadly? Well, a couple drops of their venom can kill from 3 to 5 humans. Their venom is so potent it can melt human flesh. Although it sounds like something you want to avoid, if you get bitten, trust me, you have a lot more to worry about. The combination of substances like metalloproteinases, phospholipases A2, serine proteinases, C-type lectins, disintegrins, and bradykinin potentiating peptides, present in the Golden Lancehead Viper venom, are like the perfect cocktail to quickly kill its prey. The effects on the human body, on the other hand, can vary. Pain, swelling, tissue necrosis, internal bleeding. Cardiovascular effects like hypotension. Neurological effects like dizziness, blurred vision, muscle weakness, or paralysis. Renal effects like kidney damage and renal failure can happen. So, next time your friends ask what three items you would take to an island, maybe, just maybe, you will want to consider embracing a more Bear Grylls-like approach. But how come the Golden Lancehead Vipers develop such a deadly weapon? The answer is evolution. As the Earth's climate changed, sea levels rose, and the island got isolated from the mainland. All the species that lived on the island got stranded and left to survive with limited resources. With this unique environment and lack of prey, the Golden Lancehead Vipers relied on the birds that visited the island as a source of food. Evolution took care of the rest. With fewer opportunities to catch prey, the Golden Lancehead Vipers had to evolve and develop a venom so potent that the birds would die instantly. This adaptation reduced the chances of the bird escaping and later falling into the ocean. As this venom is a great weapon for the vipers, it is also a great weapon for us humans. Venom research has led to the development of new drugs and treatments for various conditions, including cardiovascular diseases, pain management, and cancer. Conserving these vipers allows scientists to continue exploring the potential medicinal benefits of their venom. Not only that, but biodiversity is essential for maintaining a healthy and balanced ecosystem. Each species plays a vital role, and losing one can have significant effects on the web of interactions. It is also worth noting that the Golden Lancehead Vipers are an endemic species, meaning they are found exclusively on this island. So, protecting them ensures the preservation of this special and unique animal. But why would we ever step foot on such a dangerous place? Around the beginning of the 20th century, a lighthouse was built to guide ships through the treacherous waters surrounding the island. Without the help of modern technology, someone had to make sure the lighthouse was operational. So, based on previous experience and expertise in the matter, a family was picked and assigned the role of lighthouse keepers. Although it was a very dangerous task, their efforts were seen as noble, as they have played a crucial role in ensuring hundreds or thousands of sailors returned safely to their families. Over time, advancements in technology rendered the lighthouse on Snake Island obsolete, leading to its eventual abandonment. Until 2001, when the Brazilian Navy made the decision to automate the lighthouse. Since then, an annual visit to the island takes place, in order to replace the old batteries with new ones and make sure everything is working correctly. The window of opportunity was created, and it was the perfect moment to combine efforts between the Navy and the scientific community. Scientists took advantage of the Navy's geographical intelligence of the terrain and physical endurance to cut through the island's dense vegetation. While on the other hand, the Navy deepened its knowledge of the Viper that they so carefully had to avoid. With these visits, environmental entities were able to gather data and samples, allowing them to have a better understanding of the ecosystem and track the general well-being of the snake population over time. This information allowed the implementation of effective conservation strategies to preserve not only the snakes but this unique habitat. Now, for the adventurers eagerly waiting, it's time to reveal the story behind the hidden treasure. The legend has it that Incan gold estimated to be worth hundreds of millions of dollars was lost in the southeast end of the country. In the late 1500s, there was an increase in nautical activity and expeditions around the world, with many explorers venturing into uncharted territories, including the waters around Brazil. So, it is not uncommon for legends and folklore to be associated with this period, as it was a time of great adventure and danger on the high seas. Later, in 1852, a mysterious old map with the representation of the Snake Island surfaced in India. Whispers through the alleys believed that the map revealed the location of a hidden treasure. The discovery of the map, and its publication in Brazil in 1859, sparked a frenzy of treasure hunters eager to uncover the hidden riches of this mysterious place. The allure of the treasure, combined with the danger posed by the deadly snakes that supposedly guard it, created a sense of adventure and risk that drew many brave souls to the island in search of fortune. Despite the century-long treasure hunt, and the numerous attempts made by treasure seekers to find the gold, no concrete evidence of the treasure has ever been found on Ilha da Queimada Grande. The island remains shrouded in mystery, with its deadly vipers and dense jungle serving as formidable barriers to those who dare to seek the hidden treasure. So, if you're looking to be the first one, you better get your backpack ready with a flute and some incredible speakers. After all, you will only have 4,000 deadly vipers to charm while you're hunting for the gold. Good luck!